If learning web development is something that's on your bucket list for this year, I have something you are absolutely going to need. When I was first starting to learn how to program, I had two main troubles. One of them was trying to figure out what resources were good, what resources to use, and most importantly, what resources I could use without spending an arm and a leg. And also, once I had those resources, I found difficulty in pacing myself through those resources. So I created something that I would have really loved to have when I was first learning how to code, and that is a guided coding calendar. Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. I hope you guys are having an awesome day. And if this is your first time seeing me, hey, I'm Bree, and I am super happy to have you here. So what is a guided coding calendar? Well, I created a 30-day beginners HTML and CSS guided coding calendar to guide new developers on their journey through learning and exploring the first two pillars of web development, which are of course HTML and CSS. Like I said a few seconds ago, one of the things that I had a very hard time with was trying to figure out what resources to use, and some of that came from me learning in a very specific style. I am a very repetitive learner. I have to do things multiple times, and I also have to do them hands-on. And I had trouble finding resources that sort of incorporated all of the facets of learning that I needed to make things stick. And I realize this is a problem for some new developers as well, or any developers that might think like I do and just need a lot of repetition. So I personally am a very big planner. I like to plan things, and I realized when I was creating a plan for myself, I was thinking, oh, maybe new developers might benefit from something like this where they can take out the guesswork of what resources to use or what resources might be good, especially if you're on a tight budget and you don't really know if web development is going to be your thing, but you definitely want to give it a try. And also, in terms of pacing, it's very easy to either do too much or not know if you're doing enough. So what I did is basically I broke down multiple different resources and I created a guided curriculum, if you will, that spans 30 days that will give anybody who completes this journey or this challenge a great foundation in HTML and CSS. So because I learn in different ways, and I know that a lot of other people learn in different ways, this HTML and CSS guided coding calendar includes resources that also teaches the information in different ways. So we have a lot of resources that are from Free Code Camp, and some of those include practical exercises, but they also include YouTube videos for somebody who might need a little bit more visual instruction. Their actual practical guided examples on their website are really great for anybody who loves to do a lot of reading and note-taking in that way. And then we also have different exercises that are more games for anybody who's interactive like I am. I think that there should be a little bit of fun in everything, and if you don't know by now, I really like to play video games. So I think that this is really fun to incorporate as well, and it doesn't feel like so much work. So I've incorporated a few coding games as well. And then we also have a few actual coding sort of real world examples that come from places like Front End Mentor and CSS Battle, where you are developing either an actual website or a piece of CSS art. Those are just a few resources that are included in this sort of program, but combining those resources together will help you not only learn, but solidify what you're actually learning. So, what does this calendar actually cover? So, of course, we know that a beginner's HTML and CSS calendar is going to include HTML and CSS, but it's also going to include the basics of Git and GitHub and walk you through the basic commands and also creating and setting up your own profile. And it's also going to walk you through Google Chrome's developer tools. So learning Git and learning how to use the Chrome dev tools are two things I wish I would have learned a lot earlier in my career because they can be very beneficial. So that's why I'm also including them on this foundational calendar as well. So I've said calendar at least 15,000 times already. So let's take a look at the actual calendar itself. So what we're looking at now is the first version that I have created of this calendar, and it is in the PDF format, and you can go ahead and download it. I will go ahead and leave all the links below for everything. But basically, this PDF can be broken down into a few different sections. The first section is going to be a full 30-day overview of exactly what you're going to learn and what the focus might be for each day. Pages 2 through 5 are going to be detailed day-by-day overviews of exactly what videos, what activities, what games you're going to play, exactly what you're going to do during those days. And some of the resources have very long videos. One of them is about 11 hours. So of course, we're not going to watch an 11-hour in one video, but I'm really excited to include this resource on here and just give people the peace of mind of chunking it up and knowing that you shouldn't watch 2 hours of video at one time because it's really going to be too much. So that's why there's timestamps next to one of the videos, because it's going to tell you exactly which portion you should watch. And each portion covers a selected range of topics that are going to go with whatever exercises or games are composed in that day. And then the last two pages are credit to the amazing creators and the brilliant minds who have created these resources and made them free for everyone to use. And also, you're going to find a little bit of information about the calendar, about some considerations that I have for using it, and information to contact me if you'd like to. So like I said, this is a PDF version of the calendar, and if you choose to download it, I've made things a little bit easier for you by including links in all of the exercises. So if you want to download the PDF version, all you have to do is go to the day that you're looking for and click on the exercise, and it's going to take you exactly where you need to go. I have removed all of the guesswork and Google work for you. I also love this for anybody who loves to take digital notes. I would totally import this to a digital note taker like GoodNotes on my iPad. That way I can cross off the days as I do them. Or if you're looking for something a little bit different than the PDF download, I have also included a Git repo as well, which basically has the same information, but it's broken down without all of the styling. That way, in case you're more of just a text and links person, you can go ahead and view it in that way as well. And I'm going to go ahead and leave the link to the GitHub repo below. I want to take an extra second to thank all of the creators for the resources that they have created to basically free the information and allow people to learn for free. Sometimes if you want to learn something, you might not be absolutely positive if you want to make a large investment, or you might not even have the means to make the investment, but web development and getting a career in tech is still something that you want to pursue. I just want to thank them for making these resources available and free to use. So if you like the resources that they have created, be sure to follow them or support them in whatever way possible. And if you're feeling generous, I also have a Buy Me a Coffee link in my description as well. So before you get started with the calendar, I have a few considerations that I just want to discuss super quick. So the first thing is, this is a 30-day calendar. However, 30 days means 30 days. It doesn't have to be consecutive. It doesn't have to be within a certain time frame. However 30 days is going to fit into your schedule, 30 days is 30 days. If you complete it in that time, that's great. If you have to break up the days a little bit more to fit into your schedule, that's awesome as well. The only thing that matters is that you're learning, and you're learning in the way that best suits you. I will be proud of you either way. The second thing is journaling. I highly recommend that if you're going to complete this challenge, you also journal alongside of it. And you might be wondering, what am I going to journal about? Well, I'll tell you. The first thing that I would journal about is just a really quick summary of what you learned for the day. I love this because in 30 days, you're going to figure out that you learned so much that you didn't know on day one. And on day 30, you're going to go back and look and just see just 30 days ago how much you learned and how far you've come. The second thing you can also journal is any questions that you have. Again, same thing. In 30 days, you might come back to those questions and say, oh, I can answer that now, or I want to explore this a little bit further. And I also want you to document your wins. I want you to document things that make you feel good about what you're learning, or you can also do the opposite. Document things that you're really confused about. Document things that you have questions about and want to explore a little bit in the future. And the last thing I want you to consider is where to go from here. Now, at the end of 30 days, you are going to know whether web development is something you want to pursue based on how you felt about learning HTML and CSS, or you're going to know that maybe this isn't for you necessarily, but there were no funds wasted, just time invested in learning a different skill. And if that is the case, that is absolutely okay. I am proud of you for attempting the challenge and completing it. And if web development is something that you'd want to pursue, I highly recommend taking a look at JavaScript. This calendar is really just here to guide you as you learn HTML and CSS and sort of open your eyes to all of the things that you can do with web development. So that's the calendar. Are you going to start this 30-day beginner HTML and CSS challenge? I really hope so. Like I said, this is something that I really wish that I would have had when I was learning how to code. This would have made things easier because it's basically a full and free curriculum already curated, and I just have to go through the steps of doing the actual videos and exercises. So I really hope that this is something that will be helpful to you as a new developer, and I hope that it's something that will help you along your journey. This is the first thing that I have created that is remotely like this, so I would really love to know what you think about it. I would love to know if you like it, if there's something that you would tweak, if there's something that you might do a little bit differently. Please feel free to either let me know in the comments, or you can let me know on any of my social medias, which the links are always in the description. And I would just love to know what your experience is with it and if it was able to help you. So thank you guys so very much for watching. I hope this 30-day calendar will be super helpful for you. And until next time, happy coding.